हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ रिगार्डिंग अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर कॉल्ड एज इन्वेस्टिगेशन विच यूजली अकर्स इन द सब्जेक्ट कॉल्ड एज ऑडिटिंग. इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट दिस होल चैप्टर. व्हाट आर द थिंग्स इंक्लूडेड इन दिस चैप्टर विच प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल एज फार एज द ऑडिटिंग एग्जामिनेशन एंड स्पेशली द इन्वेस्टिगेशन चैप्टर इज बीन कंसर्न. सो ऑडिटिंग इज अ कंपल्सरी एक्सरसाइज, यू नो दैट. ऑडिटिंग इज अ कंपल्सरी एक्सरसाइज इन विच द समरी ऑफ PL means profit loss, balance sheet, auditor's report, presidential address are to be published in a well-known newspaper so that the people could know that their money are safe. If the auditing is done, then also it seems to be that same mistakes are there. Then an investigator is going to be appointed and then he work like a bloodhound. The work and he will work in a such a way that all the mistakes should be finded by him, and at last he will also give his report as the auditor usually gives. Now I'm going to tell you about the definitions of investigation given by the some specialist people. So according to the Spicer and Wagner, they have said the term investigation implies in examinations of accounts of the business for some special purposes. This is the perfect definition given by the Spicer and Wagner. Next is according to Lancaster. He has said that an investigation can be defined as an examination of an inquiry into the account of the business with the view to disclose the true positions of affair in relation to the special matter falling within the scope of investigation. Next comes according to R.G. Williams. He has said that an investigation visually implies such of examinations of an inquiry information, the account of the business as well, disclose the true and the statement of affairs according to the nature of matter under the investigation. So these are the some three prominent people who has given his definition, who has given his own views upon investigation, which should be taken care of in the form of definitions. Next comes the three important thing. What are those three important thing? That an investigation, a special audit and an inquiry. What does investigation means? According to the investigations, only shareholder will come to know that about company. Only shareholder will come to know about company, and anyone can do investigation in his or her company. This is the main gist of the investigation, that only shareholder will come to know about the company. Next comes a special audit. It usually occurs in the section 206. Sometimes the central government can say to do the special audit. If the company related petrol, gas, etc., like public used goods, so the price of these goods is increasing. If price of these goods is increasing, so the company who is involved in these kind of services, due to which the increment of price, the public can do oppose him. Public can oppose the company. Virodh kar sakte hain public. So in this case, the government say to do a special audit for that company if these kind of things is happening. And usually the special audit occurs by the central government. Next comes inquiry. It also said by the central government for a special checking to check the financial position of the business. If you need any responses, like you check it and tell me what's the position of that company, then you need to do an inquiry. If you want a long-term response, that you can take your full time and do the audit, then you have to go with a special audit. But you need the at-once decisions, you need at-once information regarding that institution, then you need to go with this inquiry method. Next is steps to be taken before undertaking the work of investigation. This line means what are those preparations that needs to be taken care of when we are going for doing an investigation. In this first comes objects of investigation. What is the object of investigation is being of? Like if the company says that after auditing, and then also company faces some problems related to any kind of thing, related to any kind of books of account, related to any kind of managerial decisions, then the company go for investigation and check that in at investigation he should tell that what is the object of investigation, like you need to check these books of account, I am facing problem after auditing also. Then what is the objective, objects of investigation should be taken care of before starting the work of investigation. नेक्स्ट इज यूसेज ऑफ इन्वेस्टिगेशन. वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ डूइंग द इन्वेस्टिगेशन, मतलब वो आपको क्या काम आएगा. यू नीड टू फॉलो सम, यू नीड टू ग्रैस्प सम एरर्स इफ यू आर हैविंग विद द कंपनी, और यू नीड टू चेक वेदर एनी फॉल्ट इज बीन देयर, यू नीड टू चेक वेदर एनी फ्रॉड्स इज बीन मेड ऑफ, एनी मिस्टेक्स इज देयर. सो वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस इन्वेस्टिगेशन टास्क शुड बी टेकन केयर ऑफ. Next is nature of business. Nature of business plays a very important role, because sole proprietorships contains a very limited amount of books, but in partnership, in long-term business or any kind of business contains some extra books of accounts also. So what is the nature of business? What needs to be taken care of in this nature of business, in a particular nature of business, should be known by a investigator so that he could get information regarding those things at current point of time. Next is determinations of period. What is the time durations that the investigation should be done? You need to give a certain time duration that within this time you need to complete the investigation process. And here the determinations of period will also consist that from you are getting checked books of account from which period. Like you have company, you started your company 2013, but you need to check your account from 2017. So this period is to be taken care of if you are going for an investigation. Next is opinion of specialist. Opinion of specialist here means what is the opinion of specialist, because investigation is done after auditing. So if investigator come, then he is act as a kind of an specialist. So what is his opinion after investigations also need to be taken care of. Here one thing should be also be taken care of, that after auditing also auditor also give his or her opinion that you need to follow these kind of things to avoid such mistakes. So what was that opinion given by the auditor should be known by the investigator before starting the process of investigations. Next is contact with auditor. Yes, if you have done auditing, then you are only going for an investigation process, then you can only go for an investigation process if you have completed the auditing full task. Then an investigator who is appointed to do an investigation of your company should contact your auditor and ask him that what is the auditor's report you have prepared, and checks whether which books of account consist the mistakes, consist the frauds when you have done the auditing. Then only I can get a clear cut chance that at the time of auditing this particular books involve some problems, some issues, so I could get the glimpse of those things. So he should contact with the previous auditor also. Next is special contract with the clients. A special contract with the clients means what is the special contract which you have done with your investors, with your creditors, with your debtors. What is the special contract? Like some company has appointed some people who has regularly investing the money without any break in their contract. So what is the special contract should be taken care of by the investigator. Usage of signs. Investigator and the auditor use some special symbols, special signs, so that they could get the information that what does this sign means. It's a full secrecy maintained here. So signs are only the method to communicate with each other. Next is proper work procedure. You need to follow the work procedure which has been involved while doing the investigation. You have to check all the books of account in a serial way, in a serial order, and the work procedure should also be maintained. You need not to skip a way. You can't skip anything if the company is doing investigation, because investigation means the knowing the gist of the company. So here the proper work procedure should be followed. Next is checking by fair player and efficient person. The investigator who is doing the investigation should be a fair player. He should not be the member of that company. He should not be in a such kind of person who has any kind of positive effect with that company or any kind of interest in that company. He should be a fair player, not having any kind of interest in the companies. And he should be the efficient person who knows what kind of thing should be performed while auditing as well as while investigating. Next is secrecy. Before doing investigation, investigator has to taken care of that you need to maintain the secrecy process. What you have checked, what the results you have got should be maintained in a secret way, because an investigator and an auditor can do auditing and investigator of several other companies as well. So every secrecy should be maintained here. Next is appointment and remuneration. Appointment of the investigator is just like an auditor is appointed, and the remuneration is also just like the auditor's remuneration is going to be decided. Next is report. As far as the auditor is been concerned, he also give his or her report. And as far as the investigator is been playing important role in the company, then he has also having the duty to give the accurate report to the company. Now I'm going to talk about objects of investigation. Object of investigator in this first object is to supply the necessary information in connection with purchasing a business. It means if you want to purchase any business, then you can do investigations. According to that report, you will need to take the decisions, because in that report, purchase considerations, merits, demerits, goodwill will come or not, it is been written in that report. Next is to supply the information concerned with any business at the time of admission of new partner. If having a partnership firm, then we can do admission. So how many partners are there, what is the earning capacity, whether it is correct to become the partner of this company or not, should be taken care of. So for this, the investigation should be done. Next is helpful in detection of fraud. Auditing is a general process, but if fraud is done, then here the investigator has to be taken into force, because here the auditor not able to check everything, because he only checks what you think is presented by the company, but an investigator should go in the deep of that company. So investigation is done here to helpful in detection of fraud. Next is helpful in investment of fund. For this also we can do investigation, that in which program or in which plan we are going to get more returns. So for this also investigation can be done. Next is helpful in valuations of shares of a company. If the intrinsic value is not coming correct of an asset, so investigation can be done, because it helps in valuations of shares. Next is for compensation from insurance company. If the claims are done and the claims are justified in auditor's report, then compensation should be released. Next is helpful in amalgamations and absorptions of business. What will be the share value after the amalgamation and absorption in the profits, etc. So these kind of decisions taken by the report of investigation on the behalf of this report only, it helps to know what is the value of share during the amalgamation and absorption of business. Next is knowledge about profitability and solvency capacity of company. What is the solvency position? What is the profitability position? What are the state of these two kinds of things which is involved in the company? By knowing this, we can do investigation for that also. Next is for change in current planning. For change in the current planning, company's planning regarding the profitability is correct or not. If we are not having the correct profitability, then we could take help of investigator as well while changing the planning of the company. Next is knowledge about undisclosed income. Some companies does not open their correct profit, so that tax can be reduced. So investigator will tell us that it is that profit which is shown by the company is correct or not. Next is helpful in liquidations of company. Valuation of assets and liabilities are done correctly or not should be taken care of as far as the investigation is been done and as far as the investigator work is been concerned. Next is duties of investigator. In this, first is determinations of nature, objects and purpose of investigation. Investigator should know objective, nature of business, for which purpose the investigation is done here. So determination of nature, object and purpose of investigation is kind of a duty of investigator. Next is method of work. After keeping the nature of business in mind, the method will be decided by investigator so that the main objective of the investigation will be achieved. नेक्स्ट इज इम्पार्शियलिटी, मतलब निष्पक्षता। इन्वेस्टिगेटर शुड वर्क इम्पार्शियली इन अ वे ऑफ इम्पार्शियल वे दैट बाई डूइंग बाई वर्किंग इन इम्पार्शियल वे ही शुड गिव अ फेयर रिपोर्ट। कोई भी भेदभाव नहीं होना चाहिए। नेक्स्ट इज इंक्वायरी इन टू द स्टेटस एंड करेक्टर ऑफ पर्सनल ऑफ बिजनेस, whether employees or officers, great people, are devoted to the business or not, what is the working method, what is the working procedure of them towards the business should be taken care of by the investigator also. Next is careful. Work should be done with full carefully or not, according to the evidence work should be done or not. If the government gets doubt, then the government can ask for an evidence also. So he needs to be very careful. Next is discussions or contact with auditor. Contact with auditor. If the accounts are audited, if the investigation need any information with the auditor, then he can take the help of auditor by doing some discussion. Next is adequacy of report. The purpose of investigation should be meted out in that report, which is prepared by the investigator. Next is parties of investigation. Parties of investigation, in this the first comes investigation on behalf of purchaser of a running business. Here the 7 points is there. I will tell you all those 7 points. If any business is running, so to purchase it as an investigator, there are some points which needs to be taken care of. First is earning capacity of that business. Like second is purchase consideration, that how much payment should be done, what is the correct amount of payment that should be done while purchasing this kind of business. This is the second point. Next is real profit. It's the third point, real profit, which means if you want to sell the business, then naturally he will tell the high profit. He will increase the value of asset. So an investigator should also check it, that what is the correct amount of that asset. This is the third point, which is real profit. Next comes valuation of asset, that is fourth point. In this, asset can increase and shown in the purchase considerations book at a high amount. So check it by help of expertise, by the help of specialist, by the help of investigator. Next comes, that is fifth comes, extent of liability. Whether the liability is of current business or not, whether it is paid or not, should be taken care of. This is fifth point. Sixth is estimations of the value of goodwill. What will be the value of goodwill should be taken care of as far as the investigation is being concerned while having the on behalf of purchasing of a running business. And at last, that is seventh point, is can use for selling of business. As an investigator, he should tell whether we should purchase this business or not. Next is investigation on behalf of the person who invest the money. Under this, there are 8 points. In this, first is economic position of the institutions, economic position of the concern, which means when we give loan in return of shares and debentures, then we collect information, then we do investigating. So we can do investigation and check it, what is the correct amount of return which you are going to get by purchasing these kind of shares, by investing the money into this business. Here the second comes earning capacity of the concern. The returns, the profitability, the what is the earning capacity of this business should be taken care of. Next is third is nature of business and character of manager. What kind of nature of business involved in which you are going to invest your money? What is the character of business, character of manager? It is very important, because manager should be in a positive mind, should not be in a negative opinion, should not keep always negative opinion. He should keep always positive opinion so that only he could get channelized our fund in a easy way, in a profitable way. This is the third point. Next comes trend of business. Trend of the business means what is the yearly profit gained by the business should be taken care of. Next comes fifth point, which is solvency position of the concern. That when the company is going to be insolvent, then what will be the correct amount of, what will be the amount that we are going to get if the company is going to be insolvent. So it should be taken care of while the investigation on the behalf of the person who invest the money. Sixth comes conditions of rate of return. It means that when the company is going to be insolvent, then what will be the rate of return which you are going to get? Or we can say after the certain period of time, after the certain period of the investment, invested money, when the period is going to be over, then what will be the amount of what will the amount which you are going to get, what will be the return of income which you are going to get. So these two things to be taken care of as far as the investigation on behalf of the person who invest money is being concerned. Seventh point is future of investment in the business. What will be the rate of the business? What will be the correct amount of which you're going to get on which amount which we have invested? What is the amount which is going to be exceed in that amount should be taken care of. And the eighth point is the study of capital bearing ratio. इसका मतलब होता है जो शेयर कैपिटल डिबेंचर्स है उसका जो रेशियो है वो वन से ज़्यादा है या वन से कम है. सो ओवरऑल व्हाट वुड बी द कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर, एट व्हाट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम द बिजनेस विल बी रिमेन इन द साउंड कंडीशन, इट दीज थिंग्स शुड बी टेल बाय एन इन्वेस्टिगेटर एज फार एज द इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द पर्सन हु इन्वेस्ट मनी इज बीइंग कंसर्न. नेक्स्ट इज इन्वेस्टिगेशन ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ मनी लेंडर. Here it comes 10 points, which is valuations of assets and liability, comparisons of solvency position, verifications of valuations of asset, list of secured and unsecured loans, study of ratio of assets and liabilities, estimations of earning capacity, business is insecured or not, purpose of taking loan, nature of business and ability of manager, nature of business and ability of the authority which is been concerned in that business. So these things should be taken care of whether we have to invest money in the form of loans in the company or not. So we need to take these kind of decisions by checking the investigation on the behalf of money lender. Next comes investigation on the behalf of the new partner of the business. Is there 9 points is there in this? First is to check the reasons for admissions of partner, to check the reasons for admissions of partner, effect on the working capital of the firm or institution, condition for the new partner, objective of admissions of new partner, amount of goodwill, according to partnership it is done or not, correct value of assets of the firm should be determined at the time of investigations or not, proper valuations of goodwill by the correct method is done or not, profit and loss accounts shows the correct profit or not. Next comes investigations on the behalf of government. Here 9 points is there, which is done if complaint comes regarding the company. Here first is to check the capital structures of the company, study of distributions of capital and revenue expenses, proper valuations of assets and liabilities, to check the establishment of company and its capitalization, comparative study of reserve fund, study of the investment of company and its income, study of loan taken and its conditions, study of remuneration received by the directors, and the comparative study of the dividend received. So these things should be done as far as the investigation on the behalf of government has been concerned. Next is investigation on behalf of owner of the business. Here owner tells about the frauds are suspected to the investigator. An investigator will investigate and give their report. In this first is investigation when frauds are suspected. Here 3 things come: misappropriations of cash, misappropriations of good, and manipulations of accounts. Next is investigation for the valuations of company shares, that what is the actual and what is being done. Next is investigation for giving report in prospectus. Here the auditor's report and investigator's reports both are kept in prospectus while you are going in the market to raise the funds. Next is investigation for knowledge about the uncommon fluctuations in the profit of the business. So these are the investigation which is done on the behalf of owner of the business. Next come investigation for reporting under government rules. Sometime according to the government, there are some information which are to be given to government by the company. So they can do investigation and collect information, then they can give to the government. They will treat as reliable information. Next, I am going to tell you about difference between investigation and audit, which means first is parties, on the basis of parties. If we talk about investigation, then shareholders, partner, government, anybody can do the investigation. Means outsiders can do the investigation. But in audit, for owner, by the shareholder, by the business, by the company, and the special audit done by the government. Now, next is period. No definite period for investigation. 10 years, 5 years, 15 years, 1 year. But in audit, for one final year or one half yearly. Third is objects. All the objectives told earlier are fixed here. In the investigation, all the objectives told earlier are fixed here. But in audit, main objective is that PL is true or not. PL is showing the true positions or not. Balance sheet is true or not. It should be taken care of in the auditing. Next is nature. Investigation is an intensive checking and auditing is a test checking. Next is scope. Investigation is wide, auditing is limited, because in auditing only PL and balance sheet are checked. Compulsion. Investigation, there is no compulsion of doing investigation, but it is necessary to do an auditing. Next is commencement. Where the auditing ends, investigation start, and where the accounting ends, auditing starts. Qualifications. The person who has ability to check the accounts can do the investigation, and the auditing is only be done by the chartered accountants. Vouchers. Apart from vouchers, experts, report, other document are also seen in the investigation, but in audit, done on the basis of vouchers only. Trial and error. Reality is shown in the report in the case of investigation, but in auditing, aim can be trial and error, can give the suggestions only. He could not show the reality. He only gave the suggestions in auditing. Next is criticism. In investigation, we can do criticism. We do criticism, but audit can do criticisms of accounts and give suggestion after checking if want to give. Means both investigation can also give criticism, criticize your business, and auditing can also criticize your business. Next is completeness. Investigation cannot be done partially, but audit can be done partially and can be done completely. Next is format of report. There is no defined format in investigation, but in audit, there is company act formed in which only the format is given should be followed by every auditor. Next is nature of report. Investigation, based on which type of investigation is done here, it contains elaborations, so it is very long. And auditor's report is very short, it contains of just 1 to 2 pages. At last, there is submissions of report. Appointed authority ke paas report submit hoge. Matlab report should be submitted by an investigator who has appointed that investigator. To him only the reports is going to be submit. But in auditing, auditor's report should be given to shareholders, to the partners. At least they also give the reports of auditing at the address of the partner of their houses. So auditor report is very public, and investigator should give the report the person who has appointed him to do an investigation. So this is the full video regarding the investigation chapter, which comes in auditing. So thank you for listening me. Do like and share and subscribe my channel Manish Kumar Verma Important Topics to get all the important lectures video regarding the subject of BCom. Thank you.